माननीय सदस्यगण, मुझे अपनी ओर से तथा सदन के माननीय सदस्यों की ओर से अंतर संसदीय संघ आईपीयू की प्रेसिडेंट और तंजानिया संयुक्त गणराज्य की नेशनल असेंबली की अध्यक्ष माननीय डॉक्टर तुलिया एक्सन का स्वागत करते हुए अत्यंत प्रसन्नता हो रही है। वे हमारी सम्मानित अतिथि के रूप में भारत की आधिकारिक यात्रा पर आई है। ये हमारे लिए खुशी की बात है कि डॉक्टर एक्सन बजट सत्र को देखने के लिए यहाँ उपस्थित है। माननीय डॉक्टर तुलिया एक्सन शुक्रवार दिनांक 19 जुलाई 2024 को भारत पहुंची। उन्होंने 21 जुलाई 2024 को आगरा का भ्रमण किया और इस समय वह विशेष बॉक्स में आसीन है। हम भारत में उनके सुखद और सफल प्रवास की कामना करते हैं। हम अंतर संसदीय संघ के प्रेसिडेंट के रूप में उनकी भूमिका के लिए सफलता की भी कामना करते हैं। उनके माध्यम से हम तंजानिया गणराज्य की संसद के सदस्यों, तंजानिया की सरकार तथा वहाँ की मित्र जनता को बधाई और शुभकामनाएं देते हैं। माननीय सदस्यगण, जैसा कि आपको समाचार भाग टू के माध्यम से पहले ही सूचित किया जा चुका है कि माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी के बजट भाषण की प्रतियां हार्ड कॉपी के रूप में उपलब्ध कराई जाएगी। अतः बजट प्रस्तुत हो जाने के पश्चात माननीय सदस्य कृपया बजट भाषण की अपनी अपनी प्रति प्रकाशन काउंटर से प्राप्त कर लें। आपको ये भी सूचित किया जाता है कि माननीय मंत्री द्वारा बजट प्रस्तुत किए जाने के पश्चात बजट की प्रतियां आपको मेंबर्स पोर्टल के माध्यम से भी उपलब्ध करा दी जाएगी। माननीय वित्त मंत्री श्रीमती निर्मला सीतारमण,
Honorable Speaker, I present the budget for 24-25. Introduction. The people of India have reposed their faith in the government led by Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and re-elected it for a historic third term under his leadership. We are grateful for their support, faith, and trust in our policies. We are determined to ensure that all Indians, regardless of religion, caste, gender, and age, make substantial progress in realizing their life goals and aspirations. Global context. The global economy, while performing better than expected, is still in the grip of policy uncertainties. Elevated asset prices, political uncertainties, and shipping disruptions continue to pose significant downside risks for growth and upside risks to inflation. In this context, India's economic growth continues to be the shining exception and will remain so in the years ahead. India's inflation continues to be low, stable, and moving towards the 4% target. Core inflation, that is non-food and non-fuel, currently is 3.1%. Steps are being taken to ensure supplies of perishable goods reach markets adequately. Interim budget. As mentioned in the interim budget, we need to focus on four major castes, namely the Garib, Mahilaye, Yuva, and Annadata, the poor, women, youth, and the farmer. For Annadata, we announced higher minimum support prices a month ago for all major crops, delivering on the promise of at least a 50% margin over costs. Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana was extended for 5 years, benefiting more than 80 crore people. Administrative actions for approval and implementation of various schemes announced in the interim budget are well underway. The required allocations have been made. Budget theme. Turning attention to the full year and beyond in this budget, we particularly focus on employment, skilling, MSMEs, and the middle class. I am happy to announce the Prime Minister's package of 5 schemes and initiatives to facilitate employment, skilling, and other opportunities for 4.1 crore youth over a 5-year period, with a central outlay of 2 lakh crore rupees. I will speak about them shortly, while more details may be seen in the annexure. This year, I've made a provision of 1.48 lakh crore rupees for education, employment, and skilling. Budget priorities. The people have given a unique opportunity to our government to take the country on the path of strong development and an all-round prosperity. In the interim budget, we promised to present a detailed roadmap for our pursuit of Viksit Bharat. In line with the strategy set out in the interim budget, this budget envisages sustained efforts on the following 9 priorities for generating ample opportunities for all. Number 1, productivity and resilience in agriculture. Number 2, employment and skilling. Number 3, inclusive human resource development and social justice. 4, manufacturing and services. 5, urban development. 6, energy security. 7, infrastructure. 8, innovation, research and development. And 9, next generation reforms. Subsequent budgets will build on these and add more priorities and actions. A more detailed formulation will be carried out as part of the economic policy framework, about which I will speak later in this speech. This budget details some of the specific actions to be initiated in the current year towards fulfillment of these priorities, with potential for transformative changes. The budget also covers some of the previously made announcements